And welcome back everyone to the Gloomy Channel everyone. This is another video on Echo of Soul. Today I'm going to be showing you a dungeon, the same dungeon, but on Heroic, I think it's called, definitely. And show you, if you're wondering how to reset dungeons, just a quick tip how to, if you want to keep doing dungeon runs and keep farming for certain types of loot. Now, to start with, this dungeon drops, I think, two types of loot so far. It drops the Berserker Soldier Belt, a class, which is, you can get 8 of these together and you can set up a class which gives you buffs, which I'm going for the Protector's Passion, build. So I've got 5 so far. I just need to get the Sword, the Greaves and the Boots, as you can see, kind of on the right hand side, the left hand side here. So, but you can get the Berserker stuff, which has different types. I think Berserker's more critical stuff, and the Protectors is more healing. So I'm going to show you. I've just done the dungeon again. I've done it twice so far. So I'm going to show you how you basically just reset. So you press H, you come up to dungeons. So you have Hidden Cavern at level 10, Hidden Cavern Hero at level 15, but it's actually level 17. You should do it. Once you do that, if you go to enter dungeon and do it once, that's fine. But if you're wanting to do it again straight after, you have to go to Dungeon Info and go to Reset Dungeon. Now, if you didn't know that, most people think that resets the stats, but it also resets the dungeon. So after you do that, you can basically enter dungeon, and it should be okay for you just to do a run on. Now, dungeon is not hard once you get used to it. My fastest time is 5 minutes 20 seconds, so we're going to see if we can beat that. So, we're going to start off by jump attack, and just focusing on her as quick as I can. I might actually go with Berserker build, I'm not sure yet. I'm just going to pick both maybe. So I'm trying to... I should actually have that one. I got something there, I got a ruby. So skip them two, I'd say. Go straight for these two. These are a little bit easier to kill, and not as much XP. Then do a quick wee heal with my bandage, up to 500 health at least. And we'll jump over here. I want to see if I can do it under 4 minutes. It's going to be quite challenging to do that. Now, once we do that, the Heroic is a hero difficulty, it's not that hard. It is a bit challenging. There is like stuff you have to watch out for. So we'll just jump. We're going to see if we can avoid the next one. And we'll keep going and keep attacking. So, she comes down, which is not great. We don't want her coming down now, so we want to kind of wait. So we're going to heal up while we wait. I want to see if we can get by her without aggroing, which would be nice. Which I don't think we can. We might be able to. Yeah, looks like we can get by her without aggroing. So we get by her, and we can aggro these two over in this corner. Now these are a little bit tougher than the normal ones, with 466 health. But honestly not that hard to go through if you're just kind of just pushing it as fast as you can. So 2 minutes, I think I'm already ahead of time by a good couple of seconds. So quickly gonna heal, quickly, before we fight this boss, the first one. So once we fight her, we're gonna jump in. Honestly, getting the potion up there is no use. It just wastes time, and it means you can do the dungeon run faster. And it's just easier that way. I'd say focus, or keep your T, which is your special ability. For the next one, jump out the way. Oh, she got me still. I have to do it at the right time. We're about to kill her. So, once we get that, Berserker class, not big, not too bad. It's alright, I don't mind. I'd rather have both to kind of wake up. So we have to kill these guys first. So I do. What I do is I do a quick heal up to 550. I'd say just to kind of 500 will do actually. And we're going to focus and try and get these down as fast as we can. Uh, Once we've got these guys down, we will focus on the main boss, who isn't that hard once you get the kind of rhythm down. So we'll back off to here, heal. Make sure you're fully healed. I would press your T ability once you get a chance, and use one of these. Oh, I can't have both of them at the same time. I didn't know that. See, learn something new every day. Right, so main thing you need to watch a bit harder is our AoE attacks. They're the really annoying things. So that F1, just get out as fast as you can, and then come back in as soon as it's down. The next AoE attack, if she does it, she sometimes doesn't do it. Nope, let's just this one again. Get out of that. Get back out and get ready to go back in. Easiest way to fight her, honestly, is this. Oh, bit delayed there, I was. Try to get more damage in. Right, this attack, you want to dodge, it's quite powerful. But we'll take her down in 4 minutes 36, way better than what I've done before, which is nice. Berserker Passion Armor. So, we're building up a kind of double build here. You get the Berserker stuff as well, which I want to actually look at what his buffs are like. So, the Berserker stuff does more critical but less defense. So, it looks like it's a more crit build if you're going to do that, which I'll probably work on. I'm going to keep both now and just see what I'm going to do. But we're going to leave the dungeon. Like I said, if you want to do it again, you just quickly press H, go to dungeon, click on the dungeon you want to go to, go to dungeon info, which I'll show you again. So you go dungeon info to that one, and then just reset dungeon, and it'll reset it for you. So, if you enjoyed this video, and you want some more tips in this game as I play it, leave a comment or a like below, and I'll see you next time. And always, bye.